Hi, good morning students. I hope you are practicing as well as enjoying your holidays. It is very raining during these days. I hope you are not going out for simple reasons and all. You know the reason? Alright, so now we were discussing in the last class about components of food. Alright, in that part we discussed balanced diet. As you know, the food that we eat during our day is called as diet. The diet which provides all the nutrients in a proper proportion for the proper growth of our body is called as balanced diet. Important, what is balanced diet? Okay, now come to the page number 15. You can see the figure there. Okay, whatever the food that we are going to eat is not processing all the type of nutrients that are required by our body. So some foods may contain carbohydrates or proteins or vitamins. Some of them they are not of all the nutrients that are required by our body. Example, carbohydrates and the fats are energy foods. They provide energy to us, not the proteins. Alright. See, you can see in the page number 15. There is a figure given of a person, Boju by name. What he did, instead of eating the normal food, he ate whatever this fat content food like samosa, puffs, or sweets, okay, puri, all the tasty items he ate. So, what happens if continues for a longer duration? So, it results in a condensation of a food in our body. As a result of that, that person becomes a condition called as obesity. Okay, so eating too much of fat content food results in a obesity. Okay, so next comes the part of the lesson, that is deficiency diseases. What are the deficiency diseases? See, a person may be getting enough food. He may get enough food, but he is not hiding the other food that provides the proper nutrient for the growth of the body. See, for the longer duration, if it continues, he may be eating particular type of food. It may be lack of certain type of nutrient. So if he is going to continue, if he or she is going to continue to eat the same kind of food for a longer duration, it leads to deficiency. So as a result of that, he is going to face a disease called as deficiency diseases. The person, if he is not getting all the nutrients that are required by a body in a proper proportion, so that results in a deficiency or the disorder. That type of diseases are called as deficiency disorders. For example, the person who is not eating the food which consisting of proteins results in a stunted growth, swollen face. Okay, swollen face. Right? Along with that, he may get some type of skin diseases also. Right? Stunted growth, swollen face. That you can see the picture or the figure that is given in the page number 15. Alright. So, it results in the loss of hair, discoloration of hair. Along with that, swollen face are the causes of deficiency of food. That too, the food which is not consisting of proper proteins. Alright. So the person, he or she is not eating the food which consists of proteins as well as carbohydrates. Carbohydrates along with proteins. So in such a case, it results in the complete stop of the growth. So growth all takes place. As a result of that, he will become very thin and lean. He won't possess even energy to move also. Right? Among the components of food, we studied proteins, carbohydrates, fats and all. So what happens if vitamins and minerals and some dietary fibers also, if they are not enough for meals? So here the deficiency diseases that are caused by the vitamins as well as minerals. So this table is there in the page number 16. You can observe that. Along with that, just you listen. So if the food is deficient in vitamin A, what is the effect of that? So it leads to loss of vision. He may not able to see properly. Sometimes during the night time only. Sometimes complete loss of vision if he is not eating the food which consists of vitamin A. Next, vitamin B. It is very easy to print B1, it is called. Very easy to remember why it ends with B. So by very, very weak muscles and very little energy. If he does any little work, he will become he can't able to do further work. Alright? So that is B, that this is called as disorder is called as very, very. Next comes vitamin C, scurvy. Right? What is the reason for that? Sir, person who is not eating vitamin C consistent food, okay, as you know, lemon, orange and all processing vitamin C. Alright, so along with that, the disorder caused is scurvy. So it leads to bleeding gums by biting many little hard food items. So you might have absorbed, so blood will come out. Okay. Along with that, he or she gets injury or else poor in such a case, blood will start to move out continuously. You are not going to heal quickly. So that is because of lack of vitamin C. Next. Deficiency of vitamin D causes rickets, that is, the effect is that bones become soft and bent, not able to stand properly or properly. Such a condition is called as, disorder is called as rickets, that is due to vitamin D. Next, the mineral called as calcium. So, calcium needed for bone as well as tooth. If it is not of sufficient quantity that is required by our body, it results in tooth decay as well as bone decay. So weak bones, tooth decay is the effect of that. Next comes iodine. The diseases or disorder is called as goiter. You might have observed in some type of some people, this part, neck part will be swollen. That is because of disease called as goiter, that is caused due to deficiency of mineral iodine. Next comes iron. This leads to anemia. Anemia means, so as a result of that, they will get loose motion. That causes weakness in a person. So the food which provides iron mineral, he has to eat. Right? These are the different vitamins as well as minerals, along with the deficiency or the disorder in the, and what are the symptoms of that type of disease. Along with that, each a person means he or she have to have proper dietary fibers, that is roughage and good quantity of water in order to get the proper growth or else good health. Right? I hope you followed whatever I explained. Along with that, one homework is that same table you copy as it is, one more column you prepare, and I explained you already in the earlier class. So from which sources we are getting all these minerals as well as vitamins. So you have to mention the sources of those vitamin or minerals which are responsible for these. That is a homework to you. I hope you follow. This ends your second lesson, components of food. Okay. So in the earlier class, I told you the exercise questions, whatever they, right? We discussed it earlier. All right. So once again to revise, name the major nutrients in our food that are carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals, dietary fibers, water, etc. Name the following: the nutrients which mainly give us energy, carbohydrates. The nutrients that are needed for growth and maintenance of our body, protein. The vitamin required for maintaining good eyesight, vitamin A. A mineral that is required for keeping our bones healthy, calcium. Name the two foods rich in fat, starch, dietary fiber and protein that you can do. Next, by eating rice alone we can fulfill two or four. By eating rice alone we can fulfill nutritional requirement of our body? No. Deficiency diseases can be prevented by eating balanced diet. Yes. Balanced diet for a long for the body should contain a variety of food items. Yes. And not only this one variety. So it should contain a proper nutrient that is required by body. As a result of that, not by variety of food. Okay. Meat alone is sufficient to provide all the nutrients in to the body? No. DASH is caused by deficiency of vitamin D, rickets. Alright? Vitamin D, rickets. Deficiency of DASH causes diseases known as beriberi. Yes. Vitamin B. Deficiency of vitamin causes disease known as scurvy. And night blindness is caused due to deficiency of vitamin A. So these are exercise questions. You try to write it in a homework book. This third, fourth, and fifth May you can do by yourself also by reading repeatedly the lesson two or three times. It is easy. Alright, I hope you are going to do so. And the homework is that you have to list out all the sources of this. Alright, we are going to do so. We will see the next lesson in the next class. All the best to you. Thank you.